Welcome to the Spinner Rack with your hosts, Brian and Junior.
What up, everybody? Welcome to issue 5 of the Spinner Rack. Got a full house tonight. I'm Junior, alongside my co-host,
Big B, Brian Adams.
Reflex, I saw that. He's like,
I realized I'm on the shrug. I respect. I'm David Sanchez, here joining the Spinner Rack crew.
Also, we have with us,
I'm Jonathan Paparella, a blogger and reviewer of Paparella's Point at ComicsRemixed.com.
This week's issue is all about Damien Wayne, the death, life, and Grant Morrison.
Are you guys actually devoting the entire episode to this little kid?
Totally. Yeah.
It's a lot to see what he's done.
Well, we tangent a lot, so.
Okay.
If you haven't listened to any of the previous 3 episodes,
I have.
We tend to tangent pretty
Brian,
bad.
You have a great voice.
Thank you.
I would have masturbated. I was like, I heard you call. I was like, man, it's on. my dog just looks at me weird. And I'm like, oh, I can't do this.
Peanut butter on the nuts.
It gets me out of masturbation.
Holy
He's
shit.
He's like one of those little bitch dogs, one of those shih tzus. So I was like, yeah.
Right on.
It feels awkward.
The spinner rack, folks. So, this issue dedicated to Damien Wayne.
Life, death.
And also Grant Morrison, how he had planned this from the very beginning when he introduced Damien Wayne to the DC Universe, how he already envisioned Damien's story having a ending to it.
Did he really introduce Damien Wayne, though?
Yeah.
Wasn't the concept kind of
spawned
from Son of the Demon?
Who wrote Son of the Demon?
That's a good fucking question.
That's an old book. I kind of doubt it.
Damien was introduced by Morrison.
Well, I know he wasn't named, but the son of Batman and Talia al Ghul, the idea.
Oh.
Let's not give Grant Morrison all the credit.
Gotcha. So, Brian, I know you've read everything pretty much since his inception, we'll say. From the beginning to where he ended up before Batman Inc. number 8, did you see an improvement in the character? Like, as far as, okay, you know what, this guy debuted as a cocky little bastard, but now he's kind of growing on me?
No, he was definitely a jag to start. Like I've told you before, he's really cocky. You know, I'm better than everybody. But I mean, he did grow on me a lot more than Jason Todd did. I always found Jason Todd to be the most annoying of the Robin up until Damian Wayne.
The Guy Gardner of the Robins.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. For me, absolutely. Nice. Guy Gardner of the Robins.
Don't you hate that when they do bring up these annoying characters with a purposely annoying personality, and it gets to that point where it's like, well, let's try to make him heroic. Like, with Guy Gardner, they recently really tried pushing him. He was, like, the main Green Lantern for a while. Back in the day, there was the warrior thing that happened.
Yeah, I remember
But you couldn't see that, right? Wasn't it hard to see it? Because you just kept picturing Batman punching him across the face.
Absolutely.
It was hard. It was
really
hard.
One of the best panels in comic book history.
Yeah.
I have to give you that.
One punch.
Love that shit.
So, now, you said, like you just said, you liked him better than Jason Todd.
Yeah, towards the end, I mean, he started to grow on you. Mm-hmm. You could see he was trying. I think what really made me change my opinion of Damian Wayne was the Dick Grayson era of Batman. That whole Batman and Robin, taking the concept of Batman and Robin and flipping it on its head. Mm-hmm. We've got this light, kind of like fun-loving, joking Batman, and like
a darker,
brooding Robin.
That's when Damian stepped up and became Robin.
Well, that's true.
Because before that, it was still Tim Drake.
That's right. He was just in one little prick running around beating up Robin, saying, like, I'm going to be Robin.
Yeah, and like a little ninja outfit and stuff.
So, something interesting. This is, I guess, a question for you guys. My point of view, I was never interested in the character to begin with. Because, you know, I always got to bring this up. I'm a diehard Nightwing guy. Through and through. Diehard.
You know, they relocated him from Gotham to Chicago now.
I saw that. Whoa! High five, people! All right, so a question. I want to hear from each of you. Was there a reason for this character to even exist?
Damien?
Yeah.
Outside of the purpose for Grant Morrison's story, probably not. I mean, it seems to me that Grant Morrison has taken a lot from what he liked from the comics when he was a kid, like the Batman of, I know I'm going to slaughter this, but the Zurn Ra, whatever the hell it was called. The weird multicolored.
The Zurn Ra, from R.I.P.
That's it. Yeah, from R.I.P. Because that was a 50s concept from the Batman Planet X. Which I think the only reason I even know that is because it's about action figure. It's fresh in my brain.
It's cross promotion, people.
Right, go buy the action figure. It's at Target.
No, totally. Was there a reason to introduce him? No, but I think I kind of have to go with what you said on it, the whole Grant Morrison thing. I look at it as Grant Morrison not only likes finishing, he likes tying up loose ends, whether he started them or not. Because if you think about it, if Damien was not mentioned by name, but like you said earlier, as the son of Bruce and Talia, or whatever you want to call her. So. you know, why not play with that? Because they kind of just dropped it, you know, and he's like, well, pick up the ball and run with it.
So yeah, it wasn't like a, it wasn't like an incontinuity story or anything. Like I said,
exactly.
It's just something he liked. He's like, oh, I'm going to, I mean, did he have a long game plan?
To bounce off of your ass, Adrian, who created Vulcan, the other Summers brother? Who did that storyline?
Oh, God.
Wasn't that Claremont?
Was it?
Was that back, didn't Claremont come back and do it?
It was X-Men Deadly Genesis.
Small run? Was that, I don't know.
I don't remember who wrote it. I remember Sylvester.
Google. So our the writers just hit this point where they hit a wall and they're like, well, what haven't I done yet? What is it kind of like just, yeah, maybe tie up loose ends? It's like, oh, what happened to that Summers Brothers? Damn, I gotta go back and,
you know? That was another terrible character, too.
We're not getting into that.
No, because now I'm gonna get into my Cyclops thing and I'm just gonna choke somebody, John, maybe you. There was more than enough time.
Poor John, he's like the Comics Remix whipping boy. This is all new and fresh.
You know what? I do it on purpose because John's an extrovert, and he's an introvert, and I'm an extrovert, and like I'm just waiting for the day where he just snaps me like, "Fuck you, Sanchez! Fuck you!" And like, he's hit me over the head with like this chair, and he walks away like all badass. So
that's awesome.
Just this, you keep on saying.
Just don't get any blood on the rug. Do it outside.
I'm just trying to think. What was the definition of extrovert and introvert? I can't remember.
See, I corrected myself before you could zing me. I deported you.
All right. Come on, let's get back on subject.
Back to Damien.
Now, out of the four of us here, three of us have read Batman Inc. number 8, which is the actual death issue. David, you have not read it.
No.
Brian, what did you think of the issue? Do you think... Okay, because you knew it was coming. Like that Grant Morrison said, he had a definite end in mind for Damien Wayne. Do you think the way it was carried out did the character justice? Or do you think it was just kind of like it should have been something more, maybe a little less?
I thought it was awesome, actually.
Okay.
For a character I didn't really had disdain for most of his career, I liked the end. Like, it was, what a great ending for the son of Bruce Wayne. He comes and saves everybody's ass, gives his life. Like, what more could you ask for from Bruce Wayne's son?
Do you think that's what he was going for when writing this thing? Like, he was going for this, like, I'm going to write this total jerk. And it turns out he has a heart of gold and he saves the world. You think that's what like he was going
for? Yeah, I personally do. Yeah, I think that was his idea.
Did that happen?
Well,
did that come out?
I think that like Grant Morrison kind of wanted Damien to hide that a little bit, that he's really cocky, but on the inside he's the.
Well, you got to remember when he first debuted, it was because he just came to live with Bruce because he lived with his mother, raised under the League of Shadows and everything like that. So he had that mentality, and it was the time he spent with Bruce and the rest of the Bat family that kind of made him see his, like you said, the heart.
He was raised without the empathy, without
exactly.
He was raised without that, so he didn't have that.
Exactly. So
I think Dick brought the true Damien out.
You all right,
yeah. Dick Carole, you know. I just realized that's a bad way to like Dick. No, I think Grayson brought out, you know, more out of the kid than what you had, you know what I mean? He made him change. He made him confront the arrogance and the assholeness of the kid.
He was the icebreaker for him.
Absolutely.
That was a great run, though.
Batman. Best Batman and Robin ever, man. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you read that one, right?
The one with Dick as
Batman.
Yeah.
That was good. Now, you obviously...
And it sucks that they just came and took that away.
Right? I know.
Man, I was finally happy.
Well, obviously, while he was writing it, he had the idea, okay, I'm going to kill off, quote, Bruce Wayne, and then Dick Grayson's going to step up and fill the cow, and then Damien will be promoted to a Robin and everything like that. Now, do you think he did that with the intent of boosting Damien's story, or do you think he just did that because it fit into what he was doing? You know what I mean?
No, I don't, Jamie.
Sorry.
I don't even really know if the story came naturally.
Well, yeah, that's what I meant.
I know what you're saying. Okay. Initially, the idea behind it, well, what backed this thing up was like Bruce Wayne was just not going to be a part of this.
Right.
Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. Like,
was that an actual intention?
That's what I'm saying. Do you think that was what it was? Do you think he did it where it's like, okay, I killed Bruce because I did it on purpose?
He was being killed.
Yeah. I sent Bruce through time and shot him with an Omega Beam, but do you think he did all this in order to have that storyline where Damien became Robin and Dick Grayson became Batman to help spotlight that? Or do you think it was one of those things where he wrote himself into a hole, now what do I do?
It would have been actually an interesting setup. Here's Batman, he's dead, and here's Dick kind of having to repay his life, his karma, in a sense, the way for what Bruce did for him. Now he has to do for Bruce's
Damien.
Child.
Right.
You know, that would have been actually an interesting kind of thing, kind of like reciprocating the entire process. And you would have had more probably what you... We're talking about, Brian, the things that you were raised on, you know, the the whole Batman and Dick kind of thing, you would have gotten a lot more of that. I could see Chris like as an older writer probably having more fun with that.
Mm.
You know, revising
Chris.
Yeah, I mean, sorry, you know who wrote this, but. But yeah, I could. That's actually a really good.
He's
point.
Still stuck on a side costume.
I am because I mean,
should bring him in for ambiance.
Yeah. Oh God, he'll be here for that. John, you've been kind of quiet. What do you think about all this?
What's your opinion? The first point where you asked, where like, what did I think of his death, or what was the point of the character in general?
Either one, pick one.
Personally, I didn't really like his death.
Really? Why?
Like, I think because right now, like, they're doing the whole Requiem thing, mm-hmm. or the crappy tie-ins that had nothing to do with Damien whatsoever.
Except the one.
Yes.
Oh my
one
God,
page.
He's dead. Moving on.
Yeah.
Well, you did have that whole issue of Batman. Was it Batman and Robin where he just broods the whole time?
And
the
silent
only
issue?
Script was
yeah.
just the note that Damien left.
Yeah, it was Batman and Robin 18.
That's a great
the emo
issue.
Issue.
Yeah, the
yeah.
emo
oh.
issue.
That was good, though.
It was good. I liked it. The rest of them were indeed
that,
correct.
That whole yeah. issue was better than Grant Morrison's run.
I could see what John...
Because it made sense.
Be, actually, that's how I would have felt about the whole thing. How all of a sudden he's this great hero and he sacrificed himself. Wasn't that just kind of hokey as well? Isn't that just as hokey as much as it is epic? You know, isn't that probably the more predictable?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, see, you guys, I can see how that worked. That worked for Superboy in 52. How when he took down, you know, when he sacrificed his life. I can
yeah.
see how that was set up with the, him
Infinite
and
Crisis,
Nightwing teaming
yeah,
up. Yeah,
right.
Infinite Crisis, I'm sorry. Him and Nightwing team up and they have to like go into this whole like little journey, this whole little mini team up, and all of a sudden it just leads to his death.
Yeah.
There was more of a road or a journey was taken throughout the, well, because of all of Infinite Crisis and, you know.
All right.
That was an intense journey.
Well, David hasn't...
Sorry.
No, go ahead.
I was just going to, like, add, though, like, personally, I think the death of Damien should have kind of reflected probably, like, when Bane broke Batman's back, it should have reflected something like that so it could...
So it rippled through the rest of the Bat universe for a reason?
Yeah. Yeah, so, like, it can kind of affect Bruce more.
See, that's what I thought the Requiem tie-ins would have been.
Mm,
I thought it would
right.
have something to do with that,
yeah.
but...
I mean, like, because if they had, like, what was the character's name again that killed Damien?
Damien. Technically.
Well, like, what was his actual,
yeah,
like...
What the hell was that guy?
I don't know.
Yeah.
He was actually another clone.
Yeah, he was
yeah.
a clone, but I remember
Damien.
They gave him, like, some name or something.
He wasn't Leviathan. Leviathan is...
Yeah,
Leviathan's
like
the organization.
Yeah.
I don't know. I just called him Damien. Like, the Damien clone.
Yeah.
I forgot that he even had a name.
Wait. So he brought in clones?
Totally.
I think it's...
Right.
Totally.
Well,
totally.
It's just one clone, right?
That's
it's
when
like
you know... Okay,
clones, right?
No. Potholes, time travel. That's when you know at some point a story is being written, has been discussed, is being played out, and somewhere within 8 issues or maybe 5 issues, an editor said, no, we cannot do this anymore. We're going to have to find a way to skip this part.
You know, it's funny.
So that's when you bring in either clones or time
yeah.
travel. It's bull crap.
All right, what I have in my hands right now is a copy of Batman Inc. number 8, which is the actual death. David has yet to read this book, so I'm going to hand this book over to David so he can flip through it while the rest of us discuss something here.
So I'm going
to
be super quiet.
Yeah, have fun with that.
Some grunts and moans, maybe.
Some a little bit of rubbing on off or something?
Just imagine me nodding my head. No, I'll be totally non-biased. I have not read it.
So we've got some people outside of the store acting like jackasses, and we're just saying
sad
hi.
Part is I know one of them.
They're little kids. I mean,
okay. Now going back for those that haven't read the issue, Damien.
Spoilers about?
Not really. No. Well, they've already established that Damien is technically. Well, he's not a clone, but there have been clones of him. There's a couple. I don't remember the issue specifically where they show like the lab and you see like, a bunch of embryos.
Batman Inc. Zero? No.
Well, no, I don't remember the. I'm not trying to remember the exact issue, but I'm just saying that they've already had. They've already had it set to where it's like, okay, you see that they're starting an army using Damien as a basis. The guy who murders Damien is a grown version of one of the clones. So it's like, technically he killed himself. Yes,
I guess so.
Yeah.
So what I'm getting at is, do you think...
It's a better way to die than a 900 number.
Sorry, Jason Todd. Now, do you guys think, Brian, I'll start with you. Do you think that they will bring Damien back at some point knowing now that because you've read issue 8 and issue 9, which I will get to in a second. Well, actually, I have to get to it first before I ask this question. In issue 9, there was one panel that had nothing to do with the rest of the story. Like, it the panel didn't even fit on the page compared to what the other stuff you were seeing. It's where there was two lawyers in an office, it looked like, and they were talking about how none of the Lazarus pits exist anymore. And one of them goes, well, that's not entirely true. Like, that panel came completely out of nowhere.
That was going to be my answer for you. Two words, Lazarus
pit. It's like, Batman's at a picnic. Batman's at a picnic. Oh, look, two lawyers in office. Batman's at a picnic. Right. Batman. It's like, what did that have to do with anything?
Two lawyers in the office. Lazarus pit.
Yeah. So, do you think it's a cheap cop-out? Throw the Lazarus pit in there? And if anything, do you think the Lazarus pit would, if they bring him back, Lazarus pit or one of these clones?
I think anyone that's a Batman fan, automatically, when he died, the first thing you thought was Lazarus pit. The first thing I thought was Lazarus. I mean, he's the grandson of Ra's al Ghul.
That's
true. First thing you think, Lazarus pit. Mm-hmm.
You know, it's funny because I tend to forget that. You know, I guess the character's grown on me to that point. I was like, okay, I think...
You forget he comes from such a harsh and villainous background?
Yes. My favorite Damien moment... Well, you know, I'm getting far in my head of myself, but so you thought Lazarus bit.
Absolutely.
If they bring him back.
It's comics. Of course he's coming back. No one states that unless you're Uncle Ben.
You stole my answer.
I did.
What about you, John? What do you think?
I think he'll come back somewhere down the line, but I don't think it'll be the 10-year-old version. I think it'll probably just be, like, a clone that goes rogue or something. I mean, because they... which Batman Inc. was it? Was it number 6 or something where they showed the
future?
Yeah, that future, like, the Batman 666 or whatever.
5 or 6, yeah.
I have a feeling that it's going to be, like, one of those older clones that just goes rogue, you know, because it might fit in more, you know?
I almost wonder if the 666 Batman wasn't the big clone. The
you know,
clone,
I thought about that myself.
That, like,
I mean,
was that him?
Yeah,
was it Damien? You know, fucking Grant Morrison.
Well, actually,
writer.
I want to see what they do with that older clone, too. Mm-hmm. I mean, now that, like, technically he's killed himself, what's he going to do now?
Well, the 666 is an alternate timeline. It's a possible future. Mm-hmm. So it's not saying that you killed Damien and that one won't come to pass. You know what I mean?
Right.
Now, I got another question here. Your favorite Damien Wayne moment?
Anything in the first Batman and Robin. First 12 issues of Batman and Robin. It's just the dynamic between him and Dick Grayson. I loved every minute of it.
What about you, John?
I would have to say when he's battling all the former Robins and he goes to fight...
Son of a bitch. Stole my answer.
He goes to fight Jason... He goes to fight the Red Hood. Red Bat, Jason Todd comes home, crowbars in his bed...
You stole my answer.
Damien, yep. Too subtle.
There's Batman and Robin 11, I believe.
Yes, it was.
Is that New 52?
Yeah.
It is.
You remember that one?
I dropped that book in issue 5.
I think it was issue 10, 9 or 10, where he has a meeting with the Robins, all the former Robins, including Red Hood. He calls them up to the rooftop and explains that he's going to prove that he's the best.
I do remember
by
that.
By taking them all out.
I
thought it was great. I didn't like the whole Nightwing one version of it, where he wanted to do battle Nightwing, but something else popped up, so they had to team up, and then Nightwing just ended up giving him his stick, saying, here's your trophy, you don't have to prove anything to me. But that whole thing I thought was great. You know, I was very surprised. I loved the writing on that book.
Oh, yeah.
From the very beginning.
I totally forgot about that. That was, I actually did read that.
From the very beginning, that was, like, my favorite Bat title, over Scott Snyder's. So, now that I bring up Scott Snyder,
Wasn't that Tomasi, not the...
Yeah.
Yeah.
But as I just mentioned Snyder, so I want to bring this up. Death of the Family just wrapped up about a month ago. We all read Death of the Family, except David.
Which we totally tangented into in issue 1.
Yeah, but touching back on this briefly, Death of the Family, nobody died, except a bunch of no-name cops in the very beginning. With a title like Death of the Family, do you think that would have been a better place to have killed Damien? Like, DC editorial should have been like, you know what, let's do it in there, and Grant Morrison can co-write the book with you since it's his plot. Or no, Scott, you're not allowed to kill anybody because Grant's doing it over in his book. Like, how did that play out to you?
I think it should have happened back in the family. I think I said that before, though. I think that they, editorial DC just sucks, man. They're metering the hell out of their writers left and right. I don't think there's anyone of the four of us in this group, if you read DC currently, can't argue that. They're just neutering the hell out of it.
You don't even have to read. You just look at the creative, the changes,
yeah, right?
The constant changes. In
someone's
creative.
On a book, and before an issue comes out, they're off.
Action Comics 19.
Oh, yeah.
You
know, Andy Diggle on the book. What? He's not on the book, and the book's not out yet. But the issue 19 came out, and...
And, you know, here I thought it was all just Rob Liefeld sucked. But no, and I have to rescind you. I could be like, hey, sorry, man. You're not as much produced to JF as I thought. DC editorial does suck.
What about you, John? What do you think?
I think it would have been better just because, like, so far, like, Batman's only been, like, the big book for the whole, like, Batman
franchise.
Selection.
Okay.
Yeah, the Batman franchise. And I mean, like, it would have given it, like, that shocking, surprised ending. Because, I mean, me and you were talking. Mm-hmm. We were talking about the ending. You're just kind
of
like...
Would it have been a surprise, though? Because, I mean, with the title, like, Death of the Family, you kind of expected it. So, is it a surprise that nobody died?
Maybe that was the point, though.
I would have been a little... I would have been more surprised if it was Damien instead of it was Jason Todd. Because as I was reading it, and they...
Well, Jason Todd didn't die.
Well, they kept on showing, like, Jason Todd with, like, the bandages and stuff.
Okay.
So, like, I thought, like, okay, his face would have already been scarred. You know, Joker is still tormenting him. So I was like, okay. I was like, that would have made more sense. But then it... You know,
I mean...
That was just in the fallout.
The title Death of the Family was more of a metaphor.
Yeah.
Because it pretty much killed the trust issues between Batman and his little... peoples or whatever, you know. So I honestly think when you go into a storyline with that kind of title and you have Joker as the star, somebody's gotta die.
No,
something
absolutely.
Has to. Even if you don't die, they should have did what they originally did. I mean, you talked about this briefly, David, when Joker reveals what was in the trays, and it was just all their faces, you know, and it turned out just to be a trick, just to screw with their minds. I think that would have just... I would have been okay with no death if everybody would have got their face cut off.
Well,
yeah.
Because it's Bruce Wayne. Even if I'm...
Yeah,
right,
he's
out
a billionaire.
Money.
Yeah.
You know, you can get your face put back on. It's fucking comics.
So
they did the Two-Face.
Yeah. So do you think that... Well, like you already said, DC editorial screwed it
absolutely.
Up.
Absolutely.
So you think it would have been a more fitting death if it happened in Death of the Family?
You know what? In hindsight, reading both, I really do think that maybe Scott Snyder, in this case, didn't get nipped by editorial... Maybe he meant for the death of the family to be a, you know, a metaphor and not an actual death.
Like Nick is the bond.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, now with Damien's death, it's changed everything because everyone's all like, oh, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, Bruce.
It's like, yeah, so it's like threw it out the window.
Kind of
changed
it.
Then it's kind of favoritism then, you think?
Absolutely.
As far as editorial goes.
No, absolutely.
All right, David, you look like you just finished flipping through this issue. What do you think?
Does it bother anybody else that Nightwing got knocked out because he got thrown against the display case? does it bother anybody that that's the thing that took him out?
I didn't
Meanwhile,
even notice it.
I noticed it. That's the first thing I noticed. Like I was expecting, like, I don't know, like, he gives him Apollo Driver and he's down for the count, but he does that to Nightwing and he does all this shit to Damien. And Damien still breathes for a whole other page. And comic time, what is that? A whole another 8 minutes right there?
Yeah.
Well, now I remember that the character's name. His name's Heretic.
So, yeah. That's kind of interesting. I'm trying to absorb.
I think you're just hurt because you like Nightwing.
No.
You're like, what the fuck? There's some glass and it's case
I
to the armor?
That, no, yeah. Well, think
and
about it.
And this kid's
like,
getting the shit beat out of him?
Like, it... This went through plotting, like, we have to get these guys in the room by themselves, but fuck, we just wrote them next to Grant Nightwing. Okay, we gotta separate them.
It's Grant Morrison, dude. He sucks. What do
you know? The page before, there was a giant porter. Why didn't they just, like, I don't know, have a porter roll? You know, something.
Have him get trapped under a giant
something,
porter?
Yeah, there's a plane. Why didn't the plane fall on top? Instead of... Well, he fell on the other ride.
Good old Other Robin.
Good old Other Robin. Poor Tim Drake. No
there
fucking
to cushion
respect.
The blow. Oh, God.
I'm
all
sorry,
right.
Man. Best Robin, in my opinion, Tim Drake.
Yes.
I love Dick Grayson. Agreed.
Dick Grayson
but he
is
moved
best
beyond
it.
That's
exactly.
Right.
Because
you know, he became
say,
his
Dick
own
Grayson's
god.
Nightmare
I think
now.
every character that is playing the role that they're playing is perfectly suited for them. It's not, well, they should have stayed this, you know. Like we just said, Dick makes a better Robin. I think Jason obviously makes a better Red Hood. You know, nobody obviously liked him as Robin.
Was there more that led up to this? Like how Talia was able to completely disconnect herself from Damien?
Mm-hmm.
So was there more to this?
A little bit.
Because from what I remember early on, one from when he was first introduced, like she was attached to him.
Right.
You
but
know, she did represent her.
Well,
future.
She is her father's daughter.
Yeah. So she, over time, she became this whole, not really became, but got the mental idea, okay, you know what, it's bigger than my feelings, this whole Leviathan thing, this takeover.
That doesn't make sense, because Ra's al Ghul still loved his daughter a lot.
Yeah,
but he still did a bunch of cruel and evil shit to her.
Right.
Yeah.
Well,
then
she knew.
He was trying to, the whole point was to break her in so that she could take
totally.
Over.
I don't think she wanted Damien to die, but she looks at it as, well, you know what, it's a casualty of war.
You're with me.
You gotta, yeah, you break a few eggs to make an omelet. So, obviously, this egg got stabbed.
Break a few Robin eggs.
Yeah. You know, and I think, you know, she obviously knew deep down her son was in good hands with who her father was. Who his father was.
Now, do we blame this all on Grant Morrison, though, and his inability to write anything that's worth the shit? Like, I mean, I'm not going to completely shit all over Grant Morrison, because I love Batman and Son. I love Batman Rip. Final Crisis was a fucking hot mess. Batman Inc., you know,
yeah.
Neither here nor there. The Return of Bruce Wayne, hot fucking mess.
Complete garbage.
Complete garbage. What was that? Vanishing Point. That Vanishing Point with the Time Masters and Vanishing Point or something like that?
Mm-hmm.
With Superman and Green Lantern and Rip Hunter.
Yeah.
Going through time trying to find Batman.
That was
a bunch of bullshit.
Only Grant Morrison could give us Pirate Batman and Detective.
Right.
Like Sherlock Holmes detective kind of Batman and Caveman Batman. And
did you guys get closure out of this issue?
Well, it continues in issue 9. That's like the big wrap up to it.
Yeah. I don't know, but like I don't know. Was his death fulfilling to you?
I think it was too soon. Knowing that he was a character created by Grant Morrison because he already had the end of him in mind, I think it kind of robbed me of it. Like, because I was just, like I said, this current Batman and Robin run from the New 53, I was really getting behind it. So I think they didn't give him enough time. And like you were saying, you just started coming around him. So I think they didn't give him enough time to really reach more fans, as opposed to the fans who were introduced to him and like, oh, I don't like this cocky little kid. And they dropped the book without trying to get back into it. You know, so I think it was too soon.
Hey, why can't this twin guy speak more?
John, you want to answer that? Do you know the answer?
Because this is the replacement, right?
Yeah.
This is Damien's replacement. Like,
probably something to do with, you know,
like blue blood.
Yeah, like, genetically
crossing the screen. Crossing the
screen. Yeah, don't cross the streams.
Yeah. How would you guys have felt if Talia actually killed Damien?
That would have been made more of an impact.
Yeah.
What if Talia just killed her own son?
That would have been epic.
Yeah, that would have
really
popped
her up a couple notches on the building.
When I was reading
this,
I think the way they actually the visual look of the fight scene looks pretty cool. How, you know, every once in a while a guy remembers to shoot. It's like, oh crap. You know, I think that's pretty funny. It's a cool fight scene, but it kind of like it's just this guy. He's kind of like just this guy. This guy came out and like killed Damien.
No, definitely.
Nightwing got taken out by a display case.
Who I think up to the point,
dude,
I just thought
in
was
these
this
comics,
Zubo.
Okay. In this comic world, do you know what it takes to knock out a regular superhero?
A display case, obviously.
Yeah, obviously. But
obviously, Grant Morrison has no respect for
Don't fight these guys in an IKEA.
The bane of all bat heroes, IKEA.
So, yeah, I'm not fulfilled. Somehow, I at the end, when he was dying and he was calling for his mom, I imagine Talia just kind of holding that blade, like, just right through his body. And then what would that mean? What would that mean for the entire Leviathan organization?
I think that would
have
took the whole story
crazy.
To the next
level.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Totally agree.
Even though it's going to wrap in, what, like 2-3 issues?
So, closing thoughts, Brian, on this whole Damian Wayne arc.
Thank you, sir.
Beginning, middle, end. What did you think?
Beginning, hated him. Middle, excellent. The end, probably rushed a little too quick. But we'll just blame that on Grant Morrison, the DC editor.
John, what do you think?
Death could have been... It could have been more personal and could have been played out better. Grant Morrison, I just think he could have written something better for, like, that specific issue.
Because
I haven't read the rest of the arc.
Take a couple more pills.
It's Grant Morrison. He's supposed to be, like, this great writer. He just sucks. His Action Comics is a hot mess, too.
You know why,
oh, yeah.
Right? It's, you know, I don't know, call me what you want. So, back... I don't know if you guys are into hip-hop, whatever. Back when Jay-Z was feuding with Nas... And this is the best way I can say it. One of the things that Jay-Z said about Nas's music was just because you understand or you don't understand his music doesn't mean it's good. You know, just because it's intelligent rap doesn't make it good rap. I kind of apply this to Grant Morrison. Just because you don't really understand his writing and seems a little bit more advanced, we'll say.
More highbrow.
Yeah, doesn't mean that it's great. You know, because
I
noticed a lot of people sit there and, oh, Grant, praise the hell out of Grant Morrison. Like, this great work. Why?
Not at all.
Because his stories are so intricate. They're only intricate because you don't understand it. And you don't understand it because he's writing for other drug addicts that are already hopped up as he is.
Right.
You know? So. I think it was kind of... Or, I'm sorry, I skipped you, David.
Go ahead. Thank you. Finish your point.
I think it was just too short. And my opinion kind of changed a few minutes ago when you were like, it should have been his mother that did it in. I think that totally would have rocked.
That would have been... I actually have nothing against Grant Morrison, believe it or not. Through his writing, especially his characterizations of the Bat family, I think he's a writer that's really attached to legacy. You know, how there is a lot of reference to it being Dick and Damien, as opposed to just how it was when it was like Bruce and Dick. I think he's very attached to Legacy. I really do feel something else was involved in this story being rushed through. There's nothing wrong with some high-grade writing. That's always been involved in comics. You can look back in the history of comics and kids would bring their comic books into school and be like, look, teacher, this is what I'm reading. Teachers go, oh, fuck, you know. I got to raise my bar now, you know.
Who wants to read
that? There's really nothing wrong with that. Actually, thinking about it, that probably makes me accept more that someone like Damien was created, because maybe Batman wasn't supposed to be a part of this at all. You know, if anything, there's more maybes come out of this than my anger towards Grant. Compound that with a lot of the issues that you go on Twitter, you go on Facebook, you go on all the comic social media sites, everyone's bitching about editorial. Maybe there was just another hand. That and I just finished watching X Files, so I'm all about conspiracy theories right now. The super soldier came out and it was an alien, and it made Grant Morrison rewrite the whole thing.
Well, there you go. Well, yeah. For another issue of the Spinner Rack, it's been fun, people. Please don't forget to check us out on Facebook, Comics Remix, Twitter, Comics Remix, ComicsRemix.com, SpinnerRack.podbean.com. Yeah, we're all over the place.
Big thank
YouTube.
You for John and Dave.
Yes, thank you to our special guests who will also be with us next week on issue 6. So thank you for tuning in.
Any questions, comments?
Yeah, go ahead.
SpinnerRack@ymail.com.
Yep. You guys, any final hello, goodbyes?
I think in cases like this, when we get so angry at a comic, when we feel that what we love has been defecated in some way, you know, like you just raped everything, everything I love, you know, has just been destroyed. I think sometimes that has to just be kind of like condensed down and held back a little bit and try to understand the bigger picture as to why it happened, you know, and why the fuck did it end this way?
It goes
and works. No, I'm good. I've said everything I need to say.
All right, well, for another issue of the Spinner Rack, I'm Junior.
Big B.
I'm John.
I'm David Sanchez.
We'll see you guys next week. Thanks for listening.
Peace.